I'm Christopher Zweig, and today on CJ at the Movies, I review Till, which is a biopic about the lynching of an innocent African-American boy named Emmett Till, who inspired his mother, Mamie Till, to become an activist, Mila Kunis in the made-for-Netflix drama Luckiest Girl Alive, Harris Dickinson and Woody Harrelson in the dark comedy Triangle of Sadness, and Andrea Riseborough and Marc, Maron in the alcoholic drama To Leslie. Let's take a look. Our first movie is Till, which tells the true story about Emmett Till, a 14-year-old African-American boy who traveled from Chicago to Louisiana, where he is murdered in a lynching after being accused of harassing a white woman. Danielle Deadwyler, who was smart and sassy last year in The Harder They Fall, explodes with great intensity as the dead boy's mother, Mamie Till, who wants to bring the murderers to justice, and so she goes to the last place on earth she wants to be in order to testify.
Can I at least just fix him up a bit?
No. They have to see it for themselves.
You tell me, Mamie, how is risking your life gonna help them?
Those pictures of your son change people's lives.
I can't look, Mamie. We have to.
Co-writer-director Chinawe Chukwu presents this true story at a PG-13 rating, but still makes us sad and mad at the horrors of the boy's lynching and happy that there are those willing to fight for a good cause. Deadwyler gives an Oscar-worthy performance in the way she represents Mamie's sadness and anger at her son's death and the racism. Till couldn't have come in a more timely fashion. Our next movie is Luckiest Girl Alive, based on the novel by Jessica Knoll and starring Mila Kunis as a successful New York magazine editor who is forced to confront her dark past regarding a school shooting. Was she involved with it, or did something happen to emotionally damage her?
I don't know what's me. I'm what part I invented.
Your former classmate has made claims against you.
Don't talk about what happened that night.
Are you seriously trying to threaten me right now?
Luckiest Girl Alive is a little overwhelming at times, but it is well acted thanks to Kunis, who continues to push her acting to new limits, and thanks to the screenplay by Knoll herself. When we see the accusations before we get to the past, we're curious. When we get to the past, it tiptoes in revealing the truth. And when we get to the truth, we're disgusted. Fans of the book should get a kick out of this on Netflix. Next up, Triangle of Sadness, and this is writer-director Ruben Ostlund's latest feature that satirizes the rich by giving them a luxury cruise that goes haywire. It requires seasickness, which makes these people vomit and defecate uncontrollably during a storm.
The ship is going under.
And it also requires the remaining survivors to be stranded on a desert island where karma and a social order take place.
This is really bad. This is really, really bad.
There is a subplot that goes a little over the top with Harris Dickinson and the recently departed Charlie Dean as models who have a struggling relationship, but there are also some viciously deadpan moments, some of which feature Woody Harrelson as a Marxist-American captain.
The sails. Do you think it's possible to wash them?
This is a motorized vessel.
Yeah.
So we don't have any sails.
It was sails. Yes.
Well then, in that case, we will clean the sails.
Triangle of Sadness isn't a perfect satire, but it is funny and risky as we see how these people suffer from seasickness and how their experiences give them some karma. It has its own aspects on social order, and it's not afraid to entertain us through the comedy and pathos. I know people are going to have mixed reactions given the circumstances, but I myself read between the lines. Besides, you read the reports and you saw the trailers, you knew what you were getting yourself into, so check it out! And our last movie is To Leslie, which stars Andrea Riseborough in her best performance since Disconnect as an alcoholic who blew her lottery winnings with one fell swoop. She pissed her one chance to provide her family away. Her son, played by Owen Teague, and her former friends, Allison Janney and Stephen Root, are all at their wits' end, but Marc Maron, as a motel manager, manages to give her a second chance at life by giving her a job.
I might look stupid to you.
You don't.
Yeah, well, I ain't one for letting people get over on me.
I'm not gonna do this again.
You really should see To Leslie because of the humanity and representation of a drunk who claims to be clean but still messes herself up, and yet she's able to figure out her true sadness. Riseborough, using a southern accent and wearing the right makeup, convinces us of her character's nature, while Maron delivers some fine supporting work as her new boss, who becomes her friend. Unlike Hillbilly Elegy, this movie has the nerve to overcome the addictions at a steady pace without being so angry. Don't miss it. Okay, to recap today's new movies, thumbs way up for Till, thumbs up for Luckiest Girl Alive, thumbs up for Triangle of Sadness, and thumbs way up for To Leslie. Well, those are the movies I'm reviewing today. Come back tomorrow for more reviews, including Halloween Ends. Until then, I'm Christopher Zweig. Stay safe, and I'll see you at the movies. For more amazing content, please like and subscribe to my channels, and please read my reviews at cjatthemovies.com and download the new HD Radio app.